Hey everybody, what's going on? Welcome back to another episode with the COD Geek. Today we're going to take a look at all the major changes to Warzone. Number 7. Reimagined Verdansk. Season 3 is going to drop us back into 1984 Verdansk. There are some pretty massive changes to the map. These changes really refresh the game and optimize the gameplay. It'll offer a wider variety of combat experiences for players. We're going to get all this while going back in time to tie in the extensive story of Black Ops Cold War. Number 6. Changes in Verdansk. There are going to be the most major changes when it comes to Verdansk in Season 3. The first major change we are going to see is the Gora Summit. This location is larger than pretty much any of the other multiplayer maps that we've seen. It has a central island base, three gondola stations with functional gondolas, a river valley that can be reached on foot, vehicle, or ascender, opposing helipads, multiple command centers, all on one rock island. The Gora Viaduct features 19th century engineering that spans over the Gora River Valley. It includes a dam upstream and a luscious grassland. There are a vast variety of different things that can be done here in addition to having an amazing vantage point. The Verdansk Regional Airport, yes, regional airport, because back before it was an international hub, was just a small regional airport, is another area that is going to have a lot of new things to explore and experience. The old Verdansk Stadium is being dismantled. The construction site is going to benefit as a vantage point, with some pretty stunning sightlines and parked cranes that you can drop onto. There are also going to be updates and changes for the salt mine, the broadcast tower, the grid radar tower, the old mine, the superstore, the factory, the TV station, the apartments, and so much more. I'm not even going to attempt to list everything because I would absolutely run out of breath, but just imagine everything that was old is now new again. Number 5. The flora and fauna. It seems kind of silly to even think of this, but it really adds an interesting contrast. You are at war killing the enemy, and there are beautiful flowers and animals all around you as it is springtime on Verdansk. Ah, what a pleasant place. Blood, battles, and blossoming petunias. Number 4. Ebb and Flow. There are more than massive aesthetic improvements that have been made in Season 3. Some of the improvements are ones that you may not even notice until you are deeper into playing. There have been certain obstacles removed. This is due to the shift in the time period, so they are actually a pretty fantastic attention to detail, and it also allows for faster travel around Verdansk. Number 3. Interiors and Exteriors. We can go inside more locations across the map. There are new exteriors to these locations as well because of the shift in time periods, so playing through it will feel new and fresh for most gamers. But the neat part about this updated change are the existence of new windows to shoot through, climb through, and access the interior in different ways. Number 2. The 2021 Strategy Guide. This has been fully updated and is free to use. The update includes new tactics, even the ones used by the most elite operators, hundreds of tips, meta-based loadout suggestions to utilize, and hundreds more points of interest that have been broken down into detail. The cool thing is, this guide is accessible with just internet access. You do not need to have a Call of Duty Online account to view the guide. Number 1. Cold War. There are going to be a lot of changes here with Season 3. With these changes, we are going to see connections to Cold War bloom before our eyes. We're going to see weapons like the PPS H-41 SMG and the Swiss K-31 sniper rifle. We will see some of the characters, and a few more connections that I don't want to spoil for you. What are your thoughts on the Season 3 update? Let me know in the comments down below. Thanks for watching. And as always, if you enjoyed the video, give it a like and subscribe so you never miss an episode with the COD Geek.